Hello, good morning everybody. This is Putan H., English lecturer, Department of English at Soundarya Institute of Management and Science. Today, I would like to talk about the first chapter in English for 4th sem BCom students. That is the chapter Jonathan Livingstone Seagull. It is one of the novella prescribed by the Bangalore University for 4th sem BCom students. This novella, it is written by Richard Bauch. He was one of the poet and a dramatist as well as a novelist, and basically he was a pilot. So this novella describes about Livingstone Seagull. This novella explains about how a seagull bird can fly higher and higher in the sky and faster and faster. Today, I would like to talk about few characters in the novella. What is novella? Novella, it is a very small, neatly described about a piece of literature. It's not bigger than as novel, and it's not smaller than as a poem or a lyric. So today, I would like to talk about Jonathan Livingstone Seagull. This novella brings out a curiosity and spiritualism, how to attain one's goal in our lifetime. See, the novella introduces very important three characters. The first character goes to Jonathan Livingstone Seagull. It is one of the highly talented and highly appreciable bird, and another which another flies faster and higher in the sky. So one day, what happens? So Jonathan Livingstone is flying very close to the seashore. Suddenly, he wants to meet and a few other birds in the flock. That is Sullivan. Sullivan, it is also one of the magnificent gull. It's also a bird, and who tries to fly faster in the sky, but it fails many attempts. And at the same time, the novella also introduces the last character, that is Chiang. Chiang is also one of the elderly gull, and who has become very old and who was not able to fly high and faster in the sky. So here, the entire novella divided into three parts. The part one describes about how Jonathan Livingstone Seagull attains how to fly faster and higher in the sky. At the same time, here Jonathan is going to meet Sullivan. Sullivan and rest of the other birds are not practicing, and they are not flying so fast in the sky. But by looking at Jonathan Livingstone Seagull, rest of the birds in the flock are going to, you know, appreciate and how this Jonathan has got the caliber and how he has got the extraordinary capability and stamina to fly higher and higher, faster and faster in the sky. So the second part of the novella describes about how Jonathan Livingstone Seagull is going to meet Sullivan. Sullivan is also one of the elderly bird, and who always tries to fly like that of Jonathan Livingstone, but it many times it fails to fly high in the sky. The part third of the novella, it introduces about how Jonathan Livingstone Seagull is going to teach another Chiang, an elderly bird, and how to fly faster and higher in the sky. So the entire novella, it brings out a very important message that whoever practices, see, there is a saying, you know, the practice makes man perfect. See, Jonathan Livingstone Seagull is also like a normal bird, like rest of the other seagull birds. But see, throughout his life, throughout his life, every day he spends several hours in flying higher and faster in the sky. So, but by looking at this, you know, the Jonathan Livingston seagull, we come to know that no one is perfect in the world. But unless and until we don't put practice, we don't put continuous efforts, and unless and until we don't put our labor in order to achieve a goal, and finally we are going to reach the goal and objectives in our life. So every bird has an ambition, every bird has a vision, and every bird has an objective in order to reach the goal. Because you know that every bird in the flock appreciates and admires about Jonathan Livingston seagull. Why? Because you know, such a wonderful bird, and it flies so faster, and it flies so higher and higher in the sky. Because you know, the person who is very, very active, a person who is very, very speed up in his life, is going to achieve his goal and ambition. So this is a message. And even though Jonathan Livingston seagull is a noble bird, but at the end of the day, and every bird is going to appreciate him because of his extraordinary caliber, because of his talent, because of his stamina, because of his continuous practice. And ultimately we will come to know, because you know, a person who is going to achieve something in his life is going to enjoy in inner soul or inner beauty. Because you know, there is a direct connectivity between physical stamina with that of mental stability and caliber. Because you know, living like a noble bird, Livingston, that is, you know, the Jonathan Livingston seagull, it looks like a very normal bird, but because of continuous efforts and because of continuous hard work, and every day it rises before the sun rises, it flies very, very high in the sky in order to, you know, the search for prey. So in one of the very beautiful islands, and where there are hundreds of birds have covered, and they have been nesting very close to the seashore. But this Jonathan Livingston seagull bird has become one of the extraordinary bird among all the birds of the entire the bird community. See, this novella, it brings out a very important message to all the readers, that whoever practices, or whoever puts labor, and whoever works hard with a lot of determination, ambition, and believing oneself, believing himself, and definitely, the door of success will be open forever and ever. So everyone in the bird, every seagull is, you know, wants to become like Jonathan Livingston seagull. See, in the second part of the novella, we come to know that when Jonathan meets Sullivan, and Sullivan introduces about Jonathan Livingston, and he speaks about, you know, the extraordinary caliber, and how so quick, so fast it flies high in the sky, and you know, it is easy to go for catching the prey. So here what happens, you know, when Sullivan calls Jonathan Livingston seagull, as Jonathan Livingston seagull is one of the rarest species of birds. And another, see, Jonathan Livingston seagull is one among the millions of birds, because you know, it has got the caliber, and it has got the, you know, the extraordinary power, physical strength, stamina in order to achieve his goal. See, this is one of the novella we come to know that, and anyone can achieve anything in his life, because unless and until put one's labor, and put one has to undergo a lot of work, and dedication, determination, and practice, definitely the doors of success will be open for everyone who is going to achieve with lot of hard work. See, practicing makes man perfect. So there is a saying, because you know, like Jonathan Sullivan, he is going to realize that he is going to achieve something in his life. That's why every bird in the flock are going to appreciate, admire, and everybody is going to introduce the Jonathan Livingstone seagull, because you know it is one of the best bird and it is one of the extraordinary bird who flies so high in the sky, and apart from that, it also flies very faster and faster in the sky in order to catch hold of a prey. So by this we can understand that how the Richard Bach, because Richard Bach, he was born and brought up in America, but he has a dream that he wants to fly like a bird in the sky, because he wanted to enjoy like a bird, because see, everyone has a dream. So now in this novella, Richard Bach, he speaks about how Jonathan Livingstone Seagull is going to achieve how to fly faster and higher in the sky, and how it is going to motivate rest of the other bird community to work hard and to achieve goal and objectives in one's life, because everyone in the bird community is going to appreciate, and everyone in the bird community is going to talk about Livingstone Seagull, how he flies and what kind of extraordinary caliber that he has got. So everyone is questioning Jonathan Livingstone, because how it is possible being a normal bird, and being a normal bird, how it is possible? See here, under the topic Jonathan Livingstone Seagull, it is one of the best the novella written by Richard Bach, who speaks about no one can stop anyone's ambition, determination, and reaching goal unless and until one has to achieve and one has to realize that he has a capability, he has a caliber, and he has an extraordinary talent. See, no one, because this novella, it brings out the wonderful message that no one can stop anyone's caliber, no one can underestimate anyone. Everyone can achieve and everyone can reach his or her own goal, unless and until if we put hard work and labor continuously and without any negative thoughts. So this message that Jonathan Livingstone Seagull, he brings out through the novel, that Jonathan Livingstone Seagull, it is a wonderful bird, very attractive bird. By this we can understand that no one can stop one's success unless and until one should come forward, and one should work hard, and one should dedicate, and one should determine and sacrifice himself to achieve something in one's life. So by this way, we come to know that the entire novella divided into three parts, and it is going to bring out a message how Jonathan Livingstone has become a very popular bird among the bird community in the first part, and what about the second part, and how Jonathan Livingstone is going to teach how to fly higher and faster in the sky to Sullivan, and at the end of the novella we come to know that how this man, how Richard Bach is going to introduce Jonathan Livingstone Seagull, the novella we come to know that how Jonathan Livingstone Seagull is going to teach how to fly and faster in the sky. So by this way we come to know that Jonathan Livingstone Seagull, it is one of the best and remarkable and one of the wonderful novella written by Richard Bach, and that's why we come to know that we have to learn a lot, because every student should learn that without hard work and without physical effort and without labor, and no one can achieve. So with this we come to know that Jonathan Livingstone Seagull, it is one of the remarkable, one of the excellent and magnificent the novella written by Richard Bach.